So I chose to research why excessive use of social media can cause addictive behaviors in teens. I was interested in this question because I wanted to be able to address this with my son, as he is getting pretty close to the age where he's going to start and be more involved in the internet and using social media. I want to be able to address strategies on how we can have an appropriate amount of use of the internet and social media, as well as what he is exposed to when he starts being more active on it. So I wanted to be able to come up with strategies as a parent and be able to handle this when the time comes. I found during my researching from watching the TED Talk video that Dr. Kimberly Young mentions quantifying addictive behavior is impossible. So it's the same as quantifying how many drinks an alcoholic consumes. So the same goes for if you're checking your Facebook 10 times a day, and that's okay, but checking it 11 times a day is excessive. It's impossible to put a number to what is excessive and what is addictive behavior. So, characteristics to look out for addictive behavior is poor use of the internet, how frequently you're using the internet, if it's becoming obsessive, the first thing you do when you wake up is you're checking your phone, you're checking your Facebook, see if there's any new information on there. Also, poor time management. So a lot of the times, students, teens, adolescents are given the exact tool, the internet, to help with their research, just like we are. And and that very tool is their own enemy. So they get notifications from Facebook that someone's responded to them, notifications on their phone, on their electronic devices, and it pulls them away from the task. So with that, with those constant notifications, we tend to be at the disposal of the electronic device. We're pretty much the slave to it. We're attached to it, which can lead to poor time management, obviously. So also, we found that I found during my research that reading development is lacking, as teens are not really reading, but they're scrolling, they're skimming, they're just searching for keywords, so they're not really reading as a more linear process. So I found on my research that's becoming more of a prominent problem. Also, what did you actually learn? What I actually learned is that a lot of the social media contains a lot of self-disclosure. So what I actually learned is that a lot of the time, teens, adolescents are not really thinking of what they're posting, what they're what pictures they're posting on Facebook or Twitter, internet, social medias. So they're not really being quite aware of what digital footprint they're leaving behind. Nowadays, a lot of employers would just look at your Facebook and see what kind of person you are by what you post. So really, that is just going to follow them in their adulthood and then possibly ruin the chances of getting the job that they really want. So what I actually learned is that not very many adolescents are quite aware of what they're doing, and that they need to be more knowledgeable about that. Also, I actually learned how many teens are more likely to initiate inappropriate behavior, as in drug use, alcohol use, posting sexual content, or experimenting on any of these things themselves from being exposed to the images that their friends are posting that are inappropriate. So I was unable to find the follow-through of that. So I was unable to find information on teens and adolescents initiating the actual activity after after seeing images of their peers using drugs, underage drinking, and posting sexual content. So I really had trouble trying to find actual data on that. I did find plenty of data regarding college students doing binge drinking, posting that, and then also adults. A lot of information more on 18 and older population on the use of social media and what behaviors causes to the people that are actually viewing those inappropriate images. So, what I found interesting was that there was a lot of information, a lot of feedback on help for addictive internet behaviors, for gaming, for pornography addiction, for people who were getting into 3, 4, 5 car accidents because they couldn't put their phone down because they're so addicted by it, and that there's so much help out there, that there's actually inpatients, there's inpatient hospitals to help with this addiction. Other countries around the world are starting to do surveys on teens and adolescents who are more at the risk of developing internet addictive behaviors, and they're able to survey that in students in schools, and also start a government surveillance and a government initiative to help reduce this addiction. And what I found was during the TED Talk that Kimberly Young found out that America is actually behind on this. So I would like for everyone to be more informed of this. Parents, teenagers, family, friends, to share this information, and I'd be more than happy to submit my findings, surveys to help you find out if you are addicted or if your family member's addicted, or strategies to help reduce your excessive behavior. So I would just like everyone to know that option is there for anybody to be helped with, not only teens, but also everyone is open to that information. So I hope you find this video helpful, and I hope you find my information helpful as well. So please let me know if you want any more information. I'd be more than happy to submit that to you. Thanks.